A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th October, Sunday, on the front page you have UK Parliament votes to force Brexit delay. So this is regarding the deal which had been clinched between EU and British Prime Minister Boris Johnson, but the British Parliament has not accepted it. It says the date should be delayed from 31st October. So, the defiant Prime Minister said he would not negotiate a further delay to Britain's departure from European Union after Parliament voted for this postponement. So, it was Parliament vote 322 to 306 in favour of an amendment. So, means the deal could not be accepted. So, then this is India decides to put off PM Modi's visit to Turkey. So, Indian government is upset at Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan's Kashmir stand, and also there is uncertainty over tender to Anadolu shipyard. So that is why the visit has been postponed. So you should know about Anadolu shipyard too. This is Turkey's shipyard. So the decision, expected decision, is that India would cancel the selection of Turkey's Anadolu shipyard for building naval support ships. So that is also a rift between relation between the two countries. Turkey's military operations in Syria has also been sharply criticized by India, and Turkey's stand on Kashmir has made India unhappy. So these are the concerns. So you can see about Anadolu shipyard, it is written that $2.3 billion tender was granted to Turkey's Anadolu shipyard earlier in 2019 to help build 45,000 ton fleet support ships for Hindustan Shipyard Limited, but now this will likely be cancelled. Then below you have tummy trouble, vets remove 52 kg of plastic from cow. So this is regarding a cow from the outskirts of Chennai which was brought to Tamil Nadu Vet and Animal Science University, where surgeons worked for over 5 hours to clear the waste, which included pins and needles. So 52 kg of plastic was removed from the cow. So this highlights the disastrous consequences of plastic, which it has consequences which it has on animals. On page 7 you have center should not create a bigger problem while solving existing ones. So this is what Manipur chief minister appealed to the central government. So it was 128th raising day celebrations for Manipur police, but the context in which he was speaking was on the ongoing Naga peace process and the controversy over the citizenship amendment bill. So both these issues will hurt the interest of the Manipur people. So here regarding the Naga peace process also, it is written that the Nagaland which has been demanded or the Naga nation which has been demanded by Nagas, so that will affect areas in Manipur as such to the neighboring country. So that is one concern, and what he says is the interlocutor for the Naga talks and Nagaland governor, who has said that center is determined to conclude the peace process with Naga separatist groups. So, but the center has ruled out a separate flag and constitution for Nagas, which they have been demanding. Then regarding the citizenship amendment bill, it is a matter of contention because northeastern states, they say that it will grant citizenship to non-Muslims from Muslim majority countries, neighboring countries. So, northeastern states have small population of indigenous people, and if the proposed act is passed, then these communities will be getting majority in the northeastern states. Then on page 9 you have center clarifies on definition of forest. So states need not take its approval to define what constitutes unclassified land as forest. So states will not need any approval. So the Forest Advisory Committee of the Environment Ministry, comprising independent experts and officials in the Central Forestry Division, has given this clarification. Since 2014, Ministry of Environment has been considering involving a legal definition of forest and has reportedly prepared drafts, the latest draft being in 2016. But then they were never made public, and the Forest Advisory Committee's clarification has officially signified an end to such an effort of definition of forest. So, freedom to define land not already classified as forest by the center or state records. So, if such land has been defined as forest, so this is the prerogative or the right of the state. since 1996, and it was a Supreme Court order called Godavarman judgment, which gives this right to the states. Forest Advisory Committee under the Ministry of Environment at the center is the apex body that deliberates on granting permission to industry to fell forests. So this whole issue actually began when the definition of forest as such, the judgment which came on it in 1996 by the Supreme Court, the Godavarman judgment. So in the Supreme Court said that forests include lands that were already notified by the center as forests, that appear in government records as forest, as well as those that fell in the dictionary definition of forest. So means latter definition meant that states can evolve their own criteria and say, okay, this tract of land is a forest. Then this tract of land would be bound by forest conservation laws. So these are deemed forests. Then, on international page, you have British MPs refused to back Brexit deal. What next? So, this is regarding the vote which the British Parliament has passed to delay the exit. So, it doesn't mean the Prime Minister's deal is dead, but they want to delay the exit. They want to have more time to discuss on the matter. But the British Prime Minister is not ready for that. On business page, you have RBI Deputy Governor post vacant for 3 months. So the Economics Deputy Governor sits on the Monetary Policy Committee that sets interest rate, but this has been vacant for the past 3 months now. So it was Mr. Viral Acharya whose last working day at Central Bank was July 23. And then the appointment has not been made. Then this is government appoints 3 new members to Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council. So this is a reconstitution of the council which has taken place. And this is IMF members delay quota changes, agree to maintain funding. So this is regarding International Monetary Fund. So it has agreed to maintain its funding at $1 trillion, but it has postponed changes to its voting structure. So this is a compromise between US, the fund's largest shareholder, which has resisted changes to the organization's voting structure, as well as increase in its permanent resource base. Then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage in which important issues over the week are covered. So first one is, what is the furor around the land law case? So this is regarding the Land Acquisition Act case of 2013, in which a judgment was given by the Supreme Court. And Justice Arun Mishra, he refused to recuse from the case. So this is being discussed here. What is the law all about? What was the Supreme Court judgment? How that three-judge bench Supreme Court judgment of 2014 was overturned by another three-judge bench led by Justice Arun Mishra. And now on that judgment, when a bench has been set up, Justice Arun Mishra is a member, is also part of it, which is being protested against. And this is regarding clashing with the ICC. So this says, how will cricket's governing body proposal to bring changes to the event cycle impact the plans of BCCI in India? So ICC is International Cricket Council. So its proposal changes, how will it impact BCCI in India, is being discussed. And this is our RCEP trade negotiations on sticky ground. So it has been delayed quite often. It has been going on for years now. And November deadline has been put by, but India still is uncertain over joining RCEP. So its benefits and what are its consequences, or India's issues, those are covered here. So this is very important. Then on Sundays, you have science and technology coverage. So here the first news is decoding how plant roots regenerate. So this is a particular protein which is essential ingredient for primary and lateral root regeneration, which has been understood. Like lizard grow their lost tail, zebrafish heal its wounded hearts. So these are perfect examples of regeneration. How plants root regenerate is studied. And this is how insects, pests wipe off Ajanta cave paintings. So Archaeological Survey of India is presently carrying out precautionary treatment. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage in which important international news are covered. So first one is regarding killing of a youth by ruling party linked students in Dhaka, which has resulted in huge protests in Bangladesh. Then this is regarding, a tour by Dutch, the Duke and Duchess as such, British Duke and Duchess in Pakistan. So this you can skip. And this is regarding identity politics in Sri Lanka, a movie about that. You can skip this also. And this is regarding Mongolia, where with its deep Buddhist cultural links, is promoting itself as a tourist destination, which can again be skipped. So important news here is, again, not very important, but yeah, you should know about this protests which are going on in Bangladesh. And then on the last page, you have news regarding collective animal behavior. So it says collective animal behavior began 500 million years ago. So fossils along the ocean floors reveal the earliest known instances. So these are horseshoe-shaped creatures that inched along the ocean floor in single line formation. So animals living together. And this is Mars has salt lakes similar to Earth. So Mars once had salt lakes that went through wet and dry phases similar to those on Earth. So this is what a study shows. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.